How do you begin recording your contracts into QuickBooks Online? It all starts with recording the job estimates. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Why do we make estimates in QuickBooks Online? Well, estimates are documents that we give to clients to clearly show exactly what they will be billed for in regard to completing the agreed-upon job contract. The copy of the contract can be attached to the estimate you record so you can review the actual signed contract at the moment you view the estimate. Recording them into QuickBooks Online helps you track the progress of the job's completion. Please note, however, estimates are not transactions. Making only an estimate does not affect your trial balance or chart of account balances. Recording only an estimate does not affect the balance of the customer job regarding what they currently owe. And the estimates will only show up on specific reports that we are going to view after our first two examples. So, for example, let's imagine on January 1, we made estimate number 1 for the Hanson Place job under Brown Company. We estimate that we will need 25 units of carpentry at $60 each, 25 units of electrical work at $80 each, 25 units of replacement parts at $75 each, and 25 units of steam cleaning at $55 each. Let's take a look at how to record the estimate. Now here we are in QuickBooks Online, and to make a new estimate, we go to the top left and click New, and in the left column regarding customers, click Estimate. Now notice QuickBooks Online enumerates the estimates this way, but you don't have to choose their method of numbering. You can make the estimate number anything you want anytime you open it up. Now, the customer is Brown Company, but it is specifically the Hanson Place job that we're making the estimate for. And the billing address is what we put in the previous video when we set up the jobs. The date is January 1, and we will not be using this feature in the course, but you can put an expiration date if there's a cutoff as to the date that the job must be completed by. But this is just an extra piece of data. This will not add a feature, and it will not prevent you from making invoices past this date. So if you have a job expiration date, you could put it here, but we don't. Now, we did 25 units of carpentry, electrical, replacement parts, and steam cleaning. So, from the product pull-down list, we click once to bring the arrow. Then we click on the arrow, and we choose carpentry. And the quantity will be 25. I'm going to put in the rates afterwards. I'm going to click here, 25 of electrical work. So we click the next row, and you could type EL instead of, you know, choosing it from the pull down, it will filter 25. Okay, scroll down, and the next one is replacement parts. So you could type in RE or you could simply choose it this way, and 25 of the steam cleaning. Again, it's nice to type in the first two letters and have it filter. Don't forget to put 25. And of course, now we'll come back and put in the rates, 60, 80, 75, and 55. 60, 80, 75 and 55. Now, the total estimate down here is $6,750. Of course, we did not set up rates when we set up the items list because we need to be able to charge different rates for different customers and jobs. So congratulations, you just finished your first estimate. Let's click Save and New, and let's make estimate number two. Notice QuickBooks Online saw how you like to enumerate your estimates and accommodated you by suggesting the next number in the pattern. And the next estimate will be January 2, made estimate number 2 for the Mockingbird Lane job, same customer. So we're going to put Brown Company, but this time it's the Mockingbird Lane job. And that date will be January 2. Notice it remembered the address of the Mockingbird Lane job, and the items that we will put on that estimate are 25 dewinterizing, 25 units of mason work, 25 units of replacement pipes, and 25 units of steam cleaning, and then we will put in the respective rates. So 25 units of dewinterizing. So we click here, choose dewinterizing, and put 25. To save a field, you should push the Tab key to move the cursor to the next field and save what's there. 25 units of mason work. Mason work. 25. Then, 25 units of replacement pipes. Replacement pipes. You have to be careful if two items sound very similar. 25 units. And 25 units in this estimate for the Mockingbird Lane of steam cleaning. So, steam cleaning, 25 units. Now we'll go back and put in the rates. 65, 85, 70, and 50. 65, 85, I believe it's 70 and 50. Good. Now we have estimate number two for $6,750. Now we can click Save and Close. And now let's check the results of the estimate on the estimates on the reports that show only the estimates. So there are two common reports that show the estimates: the transaction list by customer, as well as the estimates in progress invoice summary by customer. Now both of those reports are in our custom report list that we set up in a previous video. So we click Reports. Now, if you go to Transaction List by Customer, you'll see that only Brown Company has two jobs and that both of these are indented under Brown Company. But all it says is the raw number for the raw document, and this report doesn't really give you any information. But if you click here, Reports, and go down to Estimates and Progress Invoicing Summary by, well, it's kind of a long name, you double click and you can see that it shows both estimates, but it also shows that they are both 0% complete, because the percent complete depends on what you've invoiced, not what you've estimated. So that's how you record estimates, and that's how you find the estimates in the reports. You could always reopen the estimate and change or fix something if you need to just by clicking on the line of the estimate. So if I come to this line and I click, I can reopen the estimate and change anything I want to, and the numbers would change accordingly. If I scroll all the way down and click the attachment paperclip, this would be the place to click to attach the copy of the actual contract if it would help you to see the contract while you're looking at the estimate. But we won't do that. That's just a simple feature in QuickBooks Online.